Hello and welcome. My name is Daria Volkova. On this channel, we produce content to help you utilize Grafana to its full potential. This video is the second part of Build a Panel plugin for Grafana. I assume you completed the first 10 steps I described in the first part, and now you are all set to move forward. Are you ready? Let's go! Step 11. Version control. I prefer to upload my projects to GitHub early to track every development step. On my GitHub desktop, I click this menu and then Add button. Since I already have a folder to upload, I select the Add Existing Repository menu, then choose button and select my folder. Then I click the Create a Repository link. In this window, I add a description, image panel for Grafana, and click Create Repository. Now it is okay to click Cancel. At this point, the folder with my panel code has been added to the local GitHub repository. I click Publish Repository to upload the folder into GitHub server. I should select an organization for an actual project, but for my demo purposes, none is okay. Click Publish Repository. The upload is done. Now let's quickly look at GitHub by clicking this convenient View on GitHub button. Here I want to go into Actions, then the Initial Commit. You can see that the build is in progress and I can click on it. These are all building steps outlined in the scripts I originally downloaded from the Grafana on step 2, scaffolding. The Run E2E test step freezes for some unknown reason. I waited long enough and now I want to cancel workflow by clicking this button. I'm okay with the failed tests at the moment. I will fix them in the following video where I explore end-to-end tests. Step 12. Update Grafana version. On my GitHub desktop, I click the Open in Visual Studio Code button, find the Docker Composer file and replace 3.8 with 5.2. After that, when VS Code builds a Docker container, it will know to download the 9.5.2 Grafana version. I also want to set the default color theme. I use an environment variable for that. In our GitHub repository, we collected all commands, including environment variables, that can be used for Grafana customization. So I open Volkov Labs apps, Docker file, then copy this line into a clipboard, go back to VS Code, and paste the line into my Docker Compose file. Next, I want to confirm the version and live theme changes are in place. For that, I run the server script. Once it is complete, I open and refresh my localhost 3000 Grafana. Check the version. Now it is 9.5.2 and the color scheme is light. Step 13. Update dependencies. Once in a while, especially before a major release, it is a good habit to verify your project works with the latest available version of libraries. In my VS Code, I switch to terminal and run the npm update --save command. After it is complete, I want to rebuild the plugin by running the dev script. Quickly switch to Grafana and confirm I didn't break anything. Everything looks fine, which is excellent. Now I want to review the changes the npm update command made in my code. For that, I go to the GitHub desktop. It shows that three files have been changed. In the Docker Compose, two changes, version and a new environment variable. In the package JSON, I can see all these new versions of libraries that got installed. To commit to GitHub, I create a new branch with the name telling me that I updated dependencies. Here I select Bring my changes to the new branch. For the summary, I type Update dependencies and Grafana version. Now I can commit to the local version and then upload changes into the GitHub server by clicking this Publish branch. By now, I set up the version control and ensured having all the latest libraries. And Docker container is running on the latest Grafana version. Remember that at any time, you can comment a question down below. Step 15. Plugin JSON file. Go back to VS Code and open the plugin JSON file. Here I can see the plugin type, plugin name, an assigned unique ID, and description. You can modify it here. Logos are the images the plugin will have in the Grafana catalog here and in the drop-down box of all available visualizations. I'm not sure why they ask for small and large versions. SVG is a vector format and by nature scalable. I guess it's something coming from legacy. I will use the same file for both. I already prepared it and placed it under the IMG folder with the name logo.svg. Alright, go back to the plugin JSON file. In the dependencies, I specify a minimal Grafana compatible version. If anyone with earlier version attempts to install my plugin, Grafana will not allow it to happen. I will put the 9.0.0 version. It is the major stable version at the moment. Links are displayed on the left-hand side of the plugin page in the Grafana catalog. I add two links, one for documentation and the other for GitHub. Screenshots are the images displayed on the plugin page to quickly illustrate what the plugin does. I prepared the panel PNG file and placed it under the IMG folder. Since the dev script is active, it will build automatically. Now I switch to Grafana to confirm all changes are in place. Go to the Administration, Plugins, start typing Image. Here is my image plugin with the logo picture I uploaded. It is still unassigned. I will work on that in the next video. If I click on the plugin card, I have this error since the plugin is not yet signed. And I cannot verify my screenshots and my links that they are working. But trust me, they will. Step 16. Plugin options and types. Plugin options are located on the right-hand side in the edit mode. The source code is in the module.ts file. By default, I have three parameters: text, boolean switch, and the radio. The path is the option name. I change it to URL. Name is the label on the screen. I change it to image URL. Remove the description row altogether. Set the default value to https://. Remove all other options. That is all for now for the file describing the plugin options on UI. Next, I need to adjust the types accordingly. I open the types.ts file. Change the interface name to panel option. For that, I right-click on the symbol option and select the replace symbol menu. Replace symbol with panel. The parameter text replace with URL and remove to others. I do not need this type either. Remove it as well. I always add commands to clarify my code for my future self or anyone reading it. Add type is a special way to comment. For instance, if I hover over the URL, here is the prompt VS Code will generate. Now when I switch to module.js, I see panel options due to the rename action I performed a moment ago. Step 17, update component. To add test files and support multiple components, I prefer my tree folder to be well organized. I create a folder for each component, in my case image panel folder, and move the component file simple panel tsx there. I say yes to the update import question. Then I create a new file index.ts where I type export all from the component file. Next, I create another index.tx file under the components folder, and here I type export all from the component subfolder. Now I rename the simple panel TS into image panel TS and say yes to update imports. Next, I right-click on simple panel and select rename symbol. Replace simple panel with image panel. That is all for this file. I close all these files to get some fresh air. Let's get back to the module.ts file. I can simplify the import now after adding the export to the index file. Remove this long path here. And as always, I suggest commenting all your actions. For my demo, I leave some skeleton commands, but you get the idea, I hope. Now I want to resolve the errors that I got here. I go to image panel file, scroll down, and remove the unnecessary div element for the input options. I have already deleted corresponding elements from types.ts and module.ts files. The remaining issue that I still have are formatting issues. To fix them, I go to the index.ts file and add a semicolon and a new line at the end of the file. The same for the second index.ts file. Great, that brought me to the compiled successfully message and no errors found. If I go to the Grafana localhost 3000, I can see, first of all, it's working, which is a good sign, right? And in the edit mode, I have my modified options on the right section, image with only one option, image URL, and the default value I specified. It would be an excellent time to commit changes to GitHub. I skip and move forward. Step 19, update styles. I like all my styles in one single file. This way, multiple components can reuse it. One file is easier to manage and avoid duplicates. Open image panel TSX file to copy style from here. After copying it, I remove it. Then I create a new file, styles.ts, and paste the copied piece of code. Using a rename symbol menu, I replace get styles with styles. Always add a comment. Even for now, it is a basic comment. Go back to the image panel file and copy the required CSS imports. Add it to the styles.ts file. Now I can see that styles is declared but never used, so I add this export command here. Go to the image panel file, hover on styles, select quick fix, and then add import from styles menu. This new row appears. I need to update the import path to make it relative. I always add commands to all my actions. All right, what should go next? I see one more lint issue to fix here. Go to styles and add a new line at the end of the file. It compiled successfully and the message says no errors found. Now I go to image panel and rename the SVG tag to IMG, since the whole purpose of this panel is to display an image. After that, remove unnecessary parts. This G tag contains a blue circle. I will see it no more. And these three rows, I do not need them. In style.ts, I update the SVG class to IMG for the same reason of displaying an image. Remove unneeded parts. In the image panel file, replace style SVG with styles IMG and add SRC property reference to my panel options. Remove themes. I do not use them. Modify commands accordingly. Remove themes here in the import section as well. Compiled successfully, no errors found. A quick check on UI. No default vector graphic as expected. In the edit mode, I can type a URL. I specify something from our website and here you go. My image is displayed on my brand new image Grafana panel. If I want to save changes, in my case to remember the URL address I just entered, I need to provision. For that, I go to the dashboard settings, JSON model, copy the dashboard in a JSON format, go back to the VS Code, folder provisioning, dashboards, home JSON file, select all and paste from the clipboard, save. Go back to localhost 3000 and here the new image is on the panel. That means provisioning is working. Step 20, add data source. In this step, I want to read the URL dynamically from a data source. I will use a static data source at this time. I always use it for development. In the image panel file, I add this sample code. I say sample because I copied it from our Base64 panel source code from GitHub. This piece of code uses the native Grafana type, field type. I will import this type using the quick fix VS Code function. The import row is updated here and the field type error is resolved. No red underline. This code reads the image URL from the data property. The data property contains the data frames retrieved from the data source specified on the panel. This code searches for the first string fields in the data frame or for the field with the name specified in the panel options. So here is what I still need to do. Replace IMG with SRC and use a returned value SRC instead of panel options for my image. To fix this error, I go to the types file and update URL to name. Modify commands accordingly. Issues are fixed and compiled successfully. In the module TS, I replace add text input function with the add field name picker, the function I copied from our Base64 panel source code. Fix description, and resolve native Grafana types using QuickFix. Let's take a look at how it looks on UI right now. In the edit mode, I specify to use the static data source, data frame name, image name, add field with name URL, add a row, and here I mimic the value that should be coming from the remote data storage. I type the image URL. That's it. Now I have a connected data source and read the options value for my panel from the retrieved data frame. The final step is to provision. Go to the JSON model, copy this code, and then replace the existing home JSON file in my VS Code. After all 20 steps, I have a custom panel plugin for Grafana with version control and provisioning configured. I refactored the image panel component, types, and styles. My image panel displays an image specified as URL. The URL is retrieved from a data source. Remember to like this video and subscribe. If you think you learned something, let us know. Your success stories are our best inspiration. In the third part, I will cover unit and end-to-end tests, signing, release, and variables. In addition, I will add a custom editor for panel options. This is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.